top of the morning to you, and happy St. Patrick's Day, wherever you are. I am coming live today from my kind of green backyard. It's not looking super lush and green yet because we are very early spring and there's still snow on the ground here. But I did dress in as much green as I could possibly find in my closet because even my boots are green. You can't see them right now, but my children did threaten me that if I didn't wear green today that I would be getting pinched. So I tried to fully deck out in the green. And I don't know about you, but St. Patrick's Day is hands down one of my favorite holidays. So I gotta get in the spirit of today. So thanks for joining me live today for the Learn to Flourish live Facebook Live of the Week. And today's topic is around some rapid video production. Now, stay to the end because I am going to make a special announcement about a live training that we're doing next week. Instead of our live video next week, we're actually doing a webinar style training, a full training, which is particularly important for anyone who is an educator who does classroom training and in today's world is being asked to rapidly transition to delivering their content online. So stay to the end and I'll give you the details on that webinar that's coming up next week. Today we're talking about an educational tool of video, which is, as you know, one of my favorite things to teach about. We use a lot of video in the e-learning that we produce for our clients. Now, when I first started creating videos for e-learning, I went hardcore. I went to the Mac Daddy solution and I learned how to use Adobe Premiere Pro, which is the video editing tool that is used by filmmakers and professional videographers and video editors around the world. It is a very complex tool to learn how to use. But I did it, and I, you know, it's great. It's really good to have that level of skills. But at the time, I actually didn't need it because we know that including video in e-learning can make even the most boring, dull topic actually very interesting and engaging. Adding video brings things to a whole new level with the audio and visual elements and the storytelling aspects of it and the ability to draw out ideas and visualize them for people. So video is a great thing to use, but you don't necessarily have to become a professional video editor in order to create videos to incorporate into your online courses, any of the training that you're offering, or even you know, if you're wanting to do little videos for your marketing. There are other ways to do it. So today I'm going to talk about four different tools, applications that you can use to rapidly create videos using template style video creation tools. So the first one that I love to talk about is called Lumen 5. And Lumen 5 is a tool that you can sign up for free online. You use it in your web browser. And it uses the power of artificial intelligence to help you create videos quickly. So for example, what you do is you enter the text that is part of your video. So this could be, you can even use a link to a blog that you've created, or you cut and paste your text for the video into the tool. And Lumen 5 uses its artificial intelligence to match the keywords in your text and help you essentially storyboard your video out. So it's a really fun use of artificial intelligence. So that is one of the benefits of Lumen 5. It looks at your words and it helps you come up with a storyboard. Second benefit is that Lumen 5 comes with a massive library of stock assets. So what I'm talking about are photography, video clips, and background music that you can use royalty-free in your videos. There's a number of them that you could, huge amounts that you can use at their free level, and if you pay for their upgraded subscription plan, then you have access to all of their premium assets as well. So I love that. And the tool is very simple to use. Anyone who understands how to use a computer and has access to the internet can use this tool. So that's one of the tools that we have used and reviewed and love to teach people about, Lumen 5. The next tool that I have used is called Render Forest. So Render Forest is another template style video creation tools. Render Forest offers a number of preset templates that are pretty cool because they include lots of animation and motion graphics and, you know, things moving around on the screen. So they offer some really fun and interesting templates. Now, it is definitely not as easy to use as Lumen 5. I found with Render Forest, I really had to essentially storyboard my entire video and map out the entire video before I started using it. With Render Forest, you don't have access to a library of assets. You need to import all of your own photography, video clips, and music that you have sourced from somewhere else. So that is a bit of a con to it. But there is one really big benefit that I love about Render Forest. They offer a paid per render opportunity. So instead of paying for their monthly or annual subscription, if you just want one video, you can actually pay, I think it's $20 to render a single video. So this offers a great opportunity. If you love one of their templates and you just want to create one or two videos, then definitely check them out, because their use of incorporating the motion graphics just makes the videos really fun and interesting. So that might be a good option for you to look at. The third template style video creation tool that we've looked at and used is called Animoto. And this is another fun one. What I liked about Animoto is that they offer some templates that are very good for kind of step-by-step instructions. So this is really great if you are creating a video that is a training video. That was kind of the biggest benefit that I found of Animoto. I have to say they weren't my favorite, but something that they do allow that you don't have with Render Forest or Lumen 5 is it gives you the ability to record voiceover narration scene by scene. So if voiceover narration is something that's really important to you in your video, then you might want to look at the option of Animoto. Now, they don't allow a lot of flexibility with the narration. If you do have to do it scene by scene, if you want to import an audio file, they only allow a single audio file. So if you're doing background music plus voiceover narration, you would have to record those in a separate tool and import them in. But Animoto is also, it's kind of a special mention because it does have some really cool templates. The final rapid video creation tool that we have used is Adobe Spark. Adobe Spark is a tool that is part of the Adobe Creative Cloud. And so if you are already using Adobe Creative Cloud, if you already have a subscription, then this is a no-brainer. You should be checking out Adobe Spark. I actually prefer to use Adobe Spark for its social graphics capabilities and its rapid web page creation capabilities versus the video production capabilities. But here's something that I love about the Adobe Spark video templates. They have a number of templates that follow specific storyboard types. So for example, one of the video scripting techniques that we love to teach in our Video Fundamentals program and in our Learn to Flourish Academy program is called The Hero's Journey. And Adobe Spark actually has a video storyboard template that follows the hero's journey. You know, they also have one that follows if you're trying to convey a step-by-step process. So if you are already an Adobe subscriber, definitely check out Adobe Spark. It also allows you to add voiceover narration scene to scene. So, you know, the capabilities of the Adobe Spark tool for video creation are a little bit limited, but it is easy to use and it allows you to add assets from your own computer as well as not really from their library, but it provides like a rapid internet search for you to find some photography from the internet. So it's another special mention, but as I said, my favorite way to use Adobe Spark is actually for social graphics. It is the tool that we use to create all of our social graphics. So from my, those are the four tools that we have used ourselves that are rapid video kind of template style tools. And you probably noticed from my level of enthusiasm about Lumen 5, it is hands down my absolute favorite tool to show people and teach people. So if you haven't already checked out Lumen 5, definitely do it, but clear your schedule, because once you try out Lumen 5, you're probably just going to want to stay at your computer creating fun little videos all day. It is free to sign up. They have a paid, you know, you can upgrade to their subscription plan, but you, I believe right now they allow three video downloads per month. So if you're doing a lot more videos, then you might need to upgrade, but it's a really great way to kind of get your toes wet. So that's it for today, but I did want to mention a little bit more. Next week, instead of doing a live video, we are doing a special webinar. We have been getting so many questions from people who currently offer training in a classroom environment. Everyone from professors to school teachers to people who work in workplace learning environments who currently offer all of their training and education in the classroom environment and in person. Now, you know, with COVID-19, obviously, you know, that's why I'm working from home today. Everyone is, you know, workplaces are rapidly transitioning to try to provide a more virtual environment for their workers. Schools are facing shutdowns, extensions on March breaks, and a lot of schools are moving to teaching virtually for the rest of the year. So everyone is in a different situation. So because of this, we are getting a lot of questions coming in about, you know, how do we take that leap? How do we rapidly change from the classroom environment to offering training in and education in an online environment? And there are so many different stages to that. But to field some of the questions that we're getting, we're doing a special webinar at this time next Tuesday, 11 a.m. Pacific time. So if you know someone who works in education and is facing this challenge and looking for some direction on how to get started, please share the webinar information with them and let them know that they can sign up before next Tuesday morning for that live webinar, where we will be fielding questions, we'll be giving you an opportunity, some information on, you know, getting started from technology processes. How do you change your curriculum for online learning when it's been designed specifically for a classroom environment? So if you're in that situation or if you know someone else, then please share it and please join us. Sign up for the webinar so that you can save your spot. And even if you can't make the live time at 11 a.m. Pacific on next Tuesday, I believe it's March 24th, register anyway and we will send you the further education as well as the video replay from the webinar. So that's it for today. Thank you for joining me on St. Patty's Day. I hope you're safe. I hope you're well, having a wonderful St. Patrick's Day. Wishing you inspiration, innovation, and continuous learning. Bye for now.